being off 2 weeks, as you would imagine, lots going on in the hobby. We put together, what is this, got 125 slides, James? No, I'm just kidding. It's not.
I'm glad I have.
Is that a misprint?
It's not that bad. But let's dive in to this week's hobby happening, shall we? We're kicking it off with Sports Collectors Daily reported that after gathering feedback from users over the last several weeks, fractional share company Collectibles has begun selling off many of the assets on its platform and suspended trading. Launched in 2020 with support from investors, Collectible offers users the chance to own shares of high-value cards or memorabilia for as little as $5 or $10. The idea was that the items would grow in value over time and collectors would stand a profit. Now, sometimes it worked and offers were made and accepted by vote from shareholders, but more often than not, unfortunately, some items were either stagnant or saw market losses and users saw the value of their investment decline. Daily trading slowed, and by late last year, Collectible had stopped acquiring new assets altogether. CEO Ezra Levine left the company earlier this year, and users began receiving emails asking for feedback on whether they wish to have the company liquidate certain assets on the platform. The response was apparently in favor, and the frequencies of those emails has begun to increase. Some items now being auctioned through Heritage have surpassed their initial IPO value, while others appear to be likely to either sell for a slight loss or an approximate break-even point. So not all terrible as far as investors recouping their dollars. Trading has continued for assets that are still on the Collectibles IP platform. Actually, scratch that. That was the case at the time that I wrote this, but trading has since been suspended. On Wednesday, only 20 of the 187 live assets showed an increase over their IPO.
Wow. The growing popularity of Formula One racing in the United States has also led to an increased interest in trading cards collecting. Thanks to Topps, which has played a key role in the new collecting category. Alton Insights recently provided a look at the most valuable F1 cards of the top 10 drivers. Some top-level stats show that 46 of 50 of the cards were manufactured by Topps, with 4 of the 50 manufactured by Futera. Of no surprise, of the Topps cards, 26 are Topps Dynasty and 20 are Topps Chrome. Max Verstappen is on track to become the greatest driver of his generation, with 2 World Drivers' Championships under his belt, while currently leading the race for his third. His car's values have followed suit. And with 7 World Drivers' Championships, 103 wins, 192 podiums, and 103 pole positions, these records all belong to Lewis Hamilton. Since joining the circuit at 22 years of age and subsequently collecting more wins than any driver dares to dream of, his car's values reflect such excellence. Also included in the top 10 are Sergio Perez, Fernando Alonso, Carlos Sainz, George Russell, Charles Leclerc, Lance Stroll, Lando Norris, and Pierre Gasly. Be sure to check out the full detailed report on Alton Insights and read many of these drivers' collecting profiles on GoGTS.net in Future Watch.
The Sporting News featured an inspiring story about collector Greg Poole, his love of baseball cards, and his mission to help a Southern Illinois community. The hobby quite literally saved Greg's life, and now he uses the hobby to make an impact in the lives of others. You can read the full article on the Sporting News website.
SC Daily reports that if you sell a few thousand dollars in sports cards or other items on eBay or another online outlet in 2023, and worried about pending tax charges or changes, I should say, there's still a chance you won't be getting a 1099 earlier next year. The plan to force online sellers to report amounts as little as $600 to the IRS that's scheduled to go into effect this tax year is getting a challenge from two senators, one on each side of the political aisle. Senators Sherrod Brown and Bill Cassidy, MD, introduced the Red Tape Reduction Act on Thursday. The bill would take the reporting threshold from $600 to $10,000, meaning fewer casual sellers and small businesses would receive tax forms from third-party payment platforms like PayPal. Call your U.S. Senator's office and tell them you support the Red Tape Reduction Act.
Absolutely.
Yes, I do.
$600. I mean, in this hobby, you can hit that in just a couple cards or one card.
One card. Yeah.
Also from SC Daily, Chad Weldon, owner of Sports Card Junction in Pittsburgh, just completed a deal to buy approximately 500 Gaudi cards from 1933 and 1934. The deal for the cards from a private collector was more than 6 years in the making. Weldon, age 31, bought the collection, which contained about 350 cards from the 33 Gaudi set and 125 from the 1934. Plus, there was a 1935 Diamond Star card of Charlie Gehringer. The seller was a gentleman in his 60s whose father had originally bought the cards when he was a youth. The man who owned the Gaudi collection is a computer programmer in Pennsylvania. The seller had originally reached out to Weldon in 2016 before the presidential election. Weldon said, I kind of taught him how to grade cards. No sale was made, and Weldon said he did not hear back from the collector until about 2 weeks ago. I thought that deal was gone, Weldon said. Turns out he was just waiting. For more details about this fresh to the hobby find, be sure to check out the full article on sportscollectorsdaily.com.
The Card Life is currently looking for hobby shop owners and breakers interested in leveraging their social media following through paid sponsorship of premium produced content. Also, What's My Pack Wednesday last week featured sports card pioneer Terry Smith. Check out these videos.
As a local card shop owner, would you rather talk to a customer about a product or struggle to write a social media post? Organize your store or try to photograph and post about the 5 new products coming out this week? If you feel like your social media accounts are the last thing that you have time for, we have your solution. The Card Life is proud to announce the Card Life Social. Your card shop gets a full social media team, including the same Emmy Award-winning producers behind the Card Life TV show, who post engaging content on your social media accounts. And we do it for a fraction of what it costs to hire a full-time social media person. Worry about what you need to do and want to do at your card shop. Leave the social media stuff to us. For more information, log on to thecardlifesocial.com.
I played at UCLA, so, you know, I needed Lou Alcindor cards. So back then, you know, a pack of basketball cards was 10 cents. And so, you know, again, I would save up my money. And I would go buy my packs. But to give you a little story behind that, my mom would give me a dollar. And so, geez, I could get 10 packs of cards for that. But comic books were 12 cents. So, you know what? Okay, I can get a couple of packs of cards and some comics. But this thing called Taco Bell had just opened up. Tacos were 7 cents. I think burritos were 12 cents. So I started doing the math. Okay, I can go across the street. I can go to Taco Bell. I can get a couple of tacos and a burrito. And then I can go back to the drugstore. I can get some comic books and some cards. So that was a good Saturday, right? Picking up a little lunch, going home, reading the comics, and cracking open the cards.
We're back.
Very cool. In their ongoing quest to take over the hobby world one vertical category at a time, Fanatics has made yet another acquisition. ESPN and the Action Network reported this past Monday that the company had purchased marketplace and vaulting company PWCC for an undisclosed amount. The move gives Fanatics proven auction technology infrastructure and state-of-the-art vault service. The last remaining piece of the puzzle to achieve the company's goal of owning an end-to-end consumer collecting experience is grading. Mm-hmm. So which existing grading company will Fanatics end up purchasing? Answer our poll question if you haven't already done so, and we'll talk about it more when we update the poll.
Yeah, we'll talk about it. What goes into making of a Luka Doncic logo man in Panini's Flawless? Watch this and find out.
I want to talk about the quality of an...
Sorry, folks. I accidentally queued up the wrong video. So this has been...
No video?
It's been... No, I got it. I just need to change it here quick. So this will all get edited out of the thing.
Let you off for 2 weeks, James.
I know, right? It always happens when we come back.
There's you let always, the crickets into the system.
There's always
the crickets
issues.
Are chirping.
There it is. Saving the scene. All right, here we go. Luka Logo Man.
Great looking card.
That's you, Chris.
Sorry about that. Also, historic autographs is holding... Hey, we have a little bit of things. 2 weeks off, it's all good. I'll start over. Also, historic autographs is holding a huge Memorial Day sales event with discounted pricing and free Washington Chronicles blasters, free in increments of $100. Visit www.historicautographcompany.com/shop and take advantage of this great deal.
And then last, just a couple of quick notes. First, autograph tickets for the 43rd Annual National Sports Collectors Convention go on sale this coming Wednesday, May 31st. Can't believe where it's happening already. And last but not least, Daily Fantasy Sports and betting entity DraftKings has launched a sports card breaks business.
Wow.
And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.